Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This time we're going to look at some Hewlett Packard RMS voltmeters. I'm going to make two videos because those instruments are actually very different inside. And it's the inside I'm mostly interested in. But on the outside, they're extremely similar. I really like that. They're from the same time period, 1964-65, and all the way to 1980. The first video is going to be about the 3400, the RMS voltmeter. And the next video I'm going to release is about the 400 AC voltmeter. So if this is what you came for, just skip this one and go straight to the next video, okay? So here is the 3400. It's of course super easy to see here what it's doing. It's just measuring AC volts, and it's covering a huge voltage range all the way from almost nothing to 300 volts. So all that is super fantastic, and it is of course RMS volts. The special thing about this instrument is that it contains both a vacuum tube, maybe, depends on the age and version of this. We're going to figure that out. It contains a system of NPN transistors and PNP transistors and all that kind of stuff. I think you also find some of these that even consist of ICs. And yeah, so we're going to open in a minute and figure that out. There is a chopper AC amplifier and thermocouple elements. So what it's doing is it's heating up something and then measuring the temperature of the energy that you have. So that is why it is very wide band, and its capability to measure the RMS content of pulsed and really crazy shape formed signals, that is what this instrument can do much better compared to anything else. So this one don't have the same kind of features as the other one. Well, we got of course a DC output, so you can use this as an AC to DC amplifier, or you can measure this in any other way. I really like the IEC modern power connector, so that way we are pretty good going. And let's see. Sometimes you can figure this out. There is a system for H on the serial number. I think I want to go this close. My input is 1 volt RMS, and I got a 50 ohm thru load here. So I think it should definitely fit here. So this is the 3 volt, 1 volt here, depending on the angle of, oops, of my camera here. I think we are very, very, very close. Let's crank it back to 1 volt range. And that it's also just a millimeter from 1 volt here. So it's definitely not defect. And this is 1 kilohertz. So let's just crank this up to 10 kilohertz. We should not see anything yet. Let's go 100 kilohertz. And let's crank it up to 1 megahertz. Let's continue. That is 10 megahertz. Oh, exactly. So the specifications says 10 megahertz. Let's just try 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So yes, it is 10 megahertz. That is exactly what I expected. We could also go 100 hertz. Yeah. How about we try and go down to 10? that was 10. I could also go a little bit below that, 5. 4. Yeah, I kind of expected that. Now the needle is going a little bit jumpy here. But anyway, it really works. So far, so good. Let's look inside. I think we are a little bit lucky. This one is the old version. So the 3400A RMS voltmeter, the nice old one. And the reason why you can see that is we got a chopper system here with LDRs. And everything here is really nice with transistors and all that. So this is the AC amplifier. Here is the thermocouple temperature elements. They are in here. I normally do not recommend you go in here and have a look if this unit is working, because you could potentially damage something in here. So please don't do that. And here is the Nuvistor. So this is the 7586 Nuvistor tube. It's a triode. In the later versions, this is replaced with a JFET. While I'm inspecting here, I also find some other funny things. Somebody was in here before me, because look at that. There's a screw missing, and that is one of the short ones. I also figured out something funny when I took away the bottom piece. The screw just nearly touched, so just the first quarter of a turn and it fell out. So that is because it was assembled wrong. We got different length of screws. So those the short ones, they are for the sides, and the long ones, they are for the top and the bottom. So there's a reason for this, so screws can go in and get a good grip. So I'll just go and see if I can find a new one. Those are of course inch threaded screws, but we cannot have this loose kind of stuff here, right? So I lifted away the cover here so I can show you the input amplifier board with the Nuvistor. And that board is sitting here in a super flexible. I think it was once a little bit better, but today it's very, very loose. Teflon and everything nice and really nice and good here. I kind of like that. And that is, by the way, the mains transformer. It's in there. It's a little bit funny the way that this is made, because look at, okay, let me flip it around real careful so you can see. Here's the power supply and all that kind of stuff, right? And then they're using those thin wires. That is a little bit funny, isn't it? That is not how you would see it today. And you can even see that going up here and touch that screw. And this is not what you want, by the way. So here is the chopper board. Ooh, nicely gold plated. And all the cool, cool things, huh? And this is the inner workings of the chopper. So we got neon bulbs shining on LDR resistors in pairs like this. That is just so fascinating how they built this. It's a little bit odd. There isn't any wall here in the middle, but probably they don't shine so much at each other. It's almost closed like that, isn't it? Yeah, okay. Whew. We are now inside the thermal coupler Chamber of Secrets inside this one. And what is that? That is moisture nasty, not so good in there. I hope it was from the manufacturing of this, because it looks not so good. But anyway, inside those tiny little glass vacuum chambers, I can tell you that we got the wires going into the super secret little point in here. I took some macro pictures. I will try and show you exactly what we got here. But I think this is the best I can show you. Really, really a special component. Oh, I totally love it. And then they go through the PCB like that. That is so, so cute, huh? So you can imagine the point you need to heat up is very, very small. And that is why you get this nice and fine response time here. Let's look at the HP flyer from 1964, where they tell about this fantastic instrument for the first time. They tell exactly how it is new and fantastic and special, its capabilities to handle low duty cycles pulses, because of the way that it measures the power via temperature. And that is, of course, the energy content. They even show a nice little basic principle of the way that it works. And this schematic here is very, very good to understand how this thing really works. So I loved it and I wanted to include it here for you guys. Let's look a little bit on the block diagram of the model 3400. So if we see here, there's an input attenuator, the impedance converter, that is the Nuvistor tube, and then we have a second attenuator. Here comes the video amplifier, it's an AC amplifier. And then let's look at TC401 and TC402. That is the heater and the thermal coupler elements. The most important thing to see here is that the two negative sides of the temperature sensing element, they are coupled in series. So you can imagine the room temperature will not give any output signal, because room temperature will be equal on both of the two sensors. So that is the cool thing about this. The DC input is, of course, to make this the zero. And output from TC401, that is chopper amplified, filtered, and driving the meter and the DC output. So it sounds like a very, very simple block diagram, but now we just need to implement this. Frequency response test setup, and this is exactly what I've done, all the way from a very low frequency, and we figured out that it was a little bit more than 11-12 megahertz that it started to give a wrong reading. And it says here that the meter reading should be 0.95 to 1.05. So that's worst case at the ends. But in the middle, if you look here at about 1 kilohertz, or from 100 hertz to about 1 kilohertz, we should have a very, very accurate, about plus minus 1% reading. Isn't that fantastic? I think we should look a little bit on the different schematics. So this is the impedance converter assembly board. This is the one, the triode, the Nuvistor tube. It is coupled as a cathode follower. So that means it is, has a very, very high input impedance and a very relatively low output impedance. You will even see there is a bootstrap feedback to the input from the output. So that is a cute way to handle the input impedance, very, very high up in the sky here. Fantastic. I love it. You could, of course, expect the gain to drop slowly over lifetime on the front end Nuvistor and everything else here, right? So this is why I had to adjust a little bit here. There is a very, very simple adjustment procedure, and especially when it is only a full scale kind of thing, that was my problem, really. So what I'm doing here is 1 kilohertz, and this is my area of interest. Here is 1 volt RMS exactly. And I just turned it on, as you saw, right? Why, it warms up that fast, and now it works. And if we go to 3 volt, so it should be 1. Are you 1? I think you are. Can you also do 2? Let's see if the scale here is volt RMS. Is the scale linear? No? Oh, that is weird. Really? So why are you doing this? So that was 2. How about 3? Aha! Oops. And that is something that nobody can solve. It is a thing about the scale. See, 3 here is accurate. Hello. Why was it doing that? Come on, come on. Let's have a look back to 2. And then it is a little bit too low. And then if I go to 2, no, I go down to 1, and it's okay. Ew, man! So that is a problem, and that will also be a problem. We are now in 1. Okay, so that will also be a problem in 1. Volt scale is where I went. I don't know if you can see this. Let's go here, right? So this is 1. Okay, so let's go down to point. In this area here, let's go to 0.6. Like that. Mm-hmm. And then it's also a little bit low. And in this area, let's aim for 0.3. Like that. And then it's also a little bit low. Yeah, I don't know. But this is definitely within specifications, I guess. All right. So I think we had a lot of fun with this fantastic chopper, thermocouple, RMS peak pulse capable, fantastic thing.